New fears in immigrant communities this morning after huge ICE raids in several Mississippi cities. Federal immigration authorities, they arrested nearly 700 undocumented immigrants in one day. In one case, an 11-year-old girl was pleading with officers after her mother was taken into custody. CNN's Diane Gallagher live in Morton, Mississippi, where that encounter took place. Diane, what can you tell us?
Yeah, John, that little girl wasn't the only one. These raids took place on the first day of school here in Morton, Mississippi, and in the Jackson area, leaving several children without parents when they got home. Neighbors stepped in, took those kids in after what the U.S. attorney called the single largest ICE raid in a state in the nation's history. 680 people were rounded up at workplaces, these processing plants, much like where I am here. This is Cook Foods in Morton, loaded onto buses and taken to a processing area that had been set up in an airplane hangar by the in the National Guard unit area there. Now, a senior immigration official tells CNN that they'd been using informants to determine what managers and owners knew they were hiring undocumented workers. When the U.S. attorney and ICE were asked about owners and managers who had been arrested perhaps because of this, they said this was an ongoing criminal investigation. But this really rocked the community. I want you to listen to this little girl pleading with an ICE official to let her see her mother as they loaded her onto a bus.
Allá está, ¿verdad? ¿Verdad que ya es? Allá está Cynthia. ¿Verdad que ya es, mami? Ella es. No llores, mami.
Please, can I just see my mother, please?
Please.
And just really, here in the community, there is a little bit of confusion because as far as most of these people know, these individuals were just working. These were raids of workplace. These were not necessarily individuals who had criminal histories. And there's just talk of this sort of tone-deaf nature, Erica. This happened just before the president touched down in El Paso. He was supposed to be there to comfort people who were grieving because of a white supremacist who had posted a racist screed online talking about a Hispanic invasion and then killed 22 people in El Paso, most of them Latinos. So here in Mississippi, there is discussion about sort of what they called almost a victory lap that the U.S. attorney was taking, bragging about just how many people were detained. Most of those people who had children, Erica, were released. We are told that they have been united, some of them with their children, but there were still so many others, again, almost 700 people who were detained yesterday.
I want to ask about a new report from your Inspector General of DHS about an El Paso Border Patrol facility. Rooms were overcrowded at up to six times their capacity, resulting in standing room only conditions, right, making detainees stand on toilets just to get space to breathe. President Trump has called for using funds from the Pentagon to pay for his border wall. I know you want Congress to pass the money you need to expand the facilities for children and for adult migrants, but until they do, would you like to see President Trump use some of the money he's using from DOD to build the wall to help you with these facilities?
So first of all, I've been talking about my concerns about our conditions in our facilities and whether they're appropriate
for months and
especially
months
for families and children since last
absolutely
June.
Absolutely, yep.
Testified on it in December, in March. We went down to the border on March 27th and said, the border's at a breaking point.
Yep.
We have an emergency here. Our conditions are not appropriate. So I could not agree more with the IG's findings that we need a solution to change this. And we have solutions on the table with Congress. You mentioned the supplemental. We asked for $4.5 billion. 3.3 of that is to take better care of children in federal custody for HHS, not for DHS, for Health and Human Services.
Mm-hmm.
So we need that funding from Congress. We need it immediately. We've also put solutions on the table that would prevent this flow from happening in the first place. So we need help from Congress to do this effectively, but we're not resting on our laurels. I just got back from Guatemala, where we're trying to address these smuggling organizations at their point of origin. We're trying to get kids out of the cycle in the first place. So we've got a lot going on, but we need this funding from Congress so that we can provide better care for people in our facilities.
Right, you want this $4 billion from Congress, and we'll ask Jim Clyburn about that later, but until you do, would you like to see, since President Trump sees this money as very fungible, he's using some Pentagon money to build the wall, would you like to see him use some of that money to help you with the facilities so you don't have Inspector General reports in the future like the one you just got?
Yeah, we are actually working with DOD on that. They're going to help us with 7,500 additional spaces to prevent people from being too crowded in our facilities. We've already put up 1,000 temporary facility spaces on the border in Texas. We're going to add Arizona this month. We're driving as hard as we can to provide a better scenario.
Now, six children have died in custody. Six migrant children have died in government custody since September, including a 16-year-old boy who died after spending a week at a DHS facility in Texas. We know that undocumented children are being held in DHS custody longer than the legal 72-hour maximum.
Right.
What's the longest you've been holding some of these children?
So the longest cases will be when someone's gone to the hospital and spent time in hospital care. So they're still technically under our custody, but they're not in a Border Patrol station during that time. I think what we're concerned about is the average hours in custody is increasing, and that's why HHS needs this funding. They need to be able to buy additional beds, especially for teenage males, which is the number one demographic that's crossing right now unaccompanied. As children, and we need to be able to move people very quickly to HHS custody to a better situation.
So just for the people who don't know who are watching, HHS is the ones, that's the government agency charged with taking care of the migrant children.
Correct.
Whether the ones that were separated from their parents in the past, a policy that I don't think is going on any longer, or the ones who are unaccompanied. A statement from HHS to ABC News says that its agency's, quote, shelters have beds available, and they are ready to receive these unaccompanied migrant children when processed by DHS. So they say they have some beds available.
So just to clarify this and make it very clear, we've got 2,300 children in custody right now.
These are unaccompanied minors.
Unaccompanied minors in custody. HHS has on any given day 300 to 400 beds available. So yes, we're moving kids to their beds every single day, but we have many more in custody than they have capacity for. That's why they've asked Congress for a supplemental $3.3 billion to increase their capacity for beds.